Hey everybody, it's Overkill here with episode 5 of the Total War Warhammer Greenskins campaign. So in the last episode you've seen, we took Valea Soro back from the damned Top Knots, but you can see that they have two armies on their way. Their main army, led by their lord, I would imagine, and a WAG army, which is not good. We're also about to have a rebellion here in Black Crag, so I'm going to go ahead and get this army here. And these guys, I'm going to get them coming over here because I have a bit of a master plan. Now, I've been playing this these few turns over and over and over again all day with so many pissed off results. I actually contemplated ending this campaign. I contemplated restarting the campaign. I contemplated doing a Grimgore campaign because Azhag has a terrible start due to his crappy starting units compared to Grimgore's easy instant win units. But I finally came up with a way to possibly win this. If the AI does the exact same thing again, which they probably will because I've done it a couple of times and they did the same thing, we should be able to do this. So again, this might go terribly wrong, so if there's a jump to me winning against these guys or in a position to wipe these guys out, that's because I spent quite a while fixing the situation once again. So yeah, let's go ahead and get a turn out of the way. So they're gonna march towards Crooked Fang Fort. Okay. They want peace, alright? I'll accept that. Right, so they're going to go towards Crooked Fang Fort. The rebels here are going to attack me, and I'm just going to auto-resolve and win that. Alright. Jeez. So then, Azhag's army can use the underway to get over here without being attacked. Good. So then my Wa army will follow me over here. They should attack Crooked Fang Fort, and then we can attack, and everything will work out perfect. Alright, so this place is going to rebel anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and... How much do you need for this? 50%, alright. So we're going to march over to Azhag a bit closer, just in case. And we're going to go into the raiding camp, just so we get a bit of reinforcements and stuff. I'm going to make Du Bois better, so that they have better stats on the field, of course. That Wa army is going to follow me. Black Crag is going to rebel this turn. Nasty magic. These guys are really upset, so I'll go ahead and decimate them to get some fightiness back. And yeah, we should be good to go. So after we deal with the Top Knots, we should be able to come back. These guys might take this. Which is a bit of a bit of a problem, but it should be okay. I mean, I could recruit a lord. Pigkissa. I mean, I could get somebody. Oh, this guy would be a little bit shit. Minus 4 melee attack. But it would make everybody else more expensive. And yeah, look, see that? We'll actually go negative if I recruit somebody. So we're not going to do that, actually. And instead, we're just going to continue on with our plan. So, Wa army will go right here. Ish. They're over there, alright. And then they will attack Crooked Fang Fort. Yeah, okay. Like clockwork. And then the army will go there. So now, what we do is... Gosh. We take Azhag, and we attack the settlement. As you can see, that looks pretty shit, doesn't it? We're going to encircle. I'm going to give the Wa army an order to attack the army that's outside, because in doing that, this will start a battle where they won't be reinforced by this first army, but will be reinforced by Azhag's army. Got it? Alright. So now with this army, I don't quite know if I need the reinforcements. I have the potential to lose a lot of guys in this first battle. And they don't have the best troops in the world, so... Saving my settlement from being attacked by rebels would be useful. But I'm not quite sure if it's needed. So honestly, I think it would be better to just be reinforced by these guys. So we'll do that. The rebels are getting ready to attack here. No big deal though, Black Crag has a pretty good garrison and it's a walled settlement, so... Yes, so now next turn we should be able to just, our Wa army should, not even next turn, right after we click end turn, the Wa army should attack these guys. Now, they are biggins, and they have a lot of trolls, so this is going to be a dangerous battle, but we should be okay. So, let's end the turn, and we'll have a battle. Yep, there we go. Oh, wow. The balance of power is so high that it's almost pointless. I could have a battle with their second army. Yeah, we'll have a battle with the army that's actually in a town. Oh, no! I lost my biggins, are you kidding me? The only unit that was actually good. God damn it. Well, I kind of regret that now already. Oh well. Right, so those rebels are going to take this place. Yep. Or, actually... Yeah, probably. The goblins wouldn't have been so much of a big deal. But the mix of the Savage Orc Boar Boys... Savage Orc Boy Biggins, I don't know why they have those. And the trolls and stuff might be a little bit extreme. So, I'll tell you what, I'll try to play this... And I'll see if I can win. I doubt I will, but I'll see you guys on the campaign map right after this battle. Alright, so, yeah, I couldn't win. The Biggins did really well for themselves, but everything else kind of failed on me. Especially, of course, the fucking stupid archers. Goblin archers are literally the most useless shit in the world. That's why I'm so pissed off that apparently, according to this campaign, they're an elite unit that you should be very happy to have if you play as Azhag. So dumb that he starts with two units of Goblin Archers. But yeah, we're going to set a WoW target on our just recently lost town. And we are going to fight the battle here. Now I have two banners to put on. That one doesn't really do anything. And I have a Cause Terror banner. We can put it on Azhag, as he'll be in the fighting. So he'll cause terror to people, and we're not dealing with magic, so I don't think we really need to bother. So yeah, let's go ahead and fight this. I'll see you guys on the battle map. Alright, so here we are. I don't think I'm going to gamble with 12. I only have the one wizard, so I'll just go for that. Well, actually, no. Winds of Magic. Who has access to magic? Oh, my mage that's coming in, and of course he's spawning behind the enemy. Oh, God. How many of these are ranged units? Just these three. Well, I'll keep them at the front. We is gobos. They're also shit units that I wish I didn't have. All right. Whoa! Goblins, I'm just gonna have as a wide flanking unit. Boar boys will get over here. Two characters we'll have over there. You know what? I'll keep all of the cav together over on that side. Alright. Yeah, I need to get over there, like, now. Ooh. I'm gonna get them over here to harass these boar boys. Oh, and all I'm gonna get are these two. Oh, shit, they need to run. Because, yeah, I already have a huge army. That is very true. So what spells do I have for this guy? The buff and the debuff. Alright, good. We'll definitely try to use those as best as possible. Ooh, this side is really weak. Interesting. I probably should have merged them together before this battle started. That was a mistake. Alright, they're interested. Oh, maybe actually they're defending their, archers. Either way, I'm gonna go ahead and start shooting at them. Because these guys don't have much armor. But it's still enough to stop my arrows. Alright. So yeah, I'm definitely going to need to use cavalry to support these guys, because they will not hold at all. So it's telling me that I have a really good chance of winning this. Oh, this is literally the edge of the map. I don't like that. Get out of there. Stickers ready. Alright. Oh, one unit didn't want to leave them alone apparently. Alright. No big deal. So it's giving them a lot better of a chance now than it had than it did before, which is a bit unnerving. Oh, their infantry actually ends here. Oh, so what am I doing? Attack like that then. Of course. Use these guys as like reserves or something. Foolish. Wah. Little wah. Alright, so yeah, we're doing lots of damage to them because they're just ignoring my archers, which is great. I like that. I really like that. I should probably get the two characters up here, shouldn't I? I got some archers over here that we could charge. Once I'm gonna get my infantry engaged rather first, then we can bother actually attacking with the cavalry. Doing loads of damage there, that's good. Maybe not loads, but you know what I mean. Not bad. Let's get the shaman in there. Shaman, whatever. Oh, their archers are attacking. Alright. Time for a walk! So let's go. Let's get the boar boys on these guys. Spiders. Wolf riders. I should have put some cavalry on the other sides, but oh well. Gobbo's rule. Here they go. Wong! Orc versus orc. That's right. God, they're slow. They're probably tired though, so. I guess it makes sense. Alright, so this is going pretty good. Those guys charge into me, that's fine. We are the Green Tide! Alright, good, we're doing good. My characters are all the way back there. My shaman is nowhere to be seen, he's all the way back here. But yeah, we're starting to break all of their units, so that's good. Mork says it, we do it. That's right. The way it should be. Alright. There we go. That's how you defeat a savage orc. You use real tactics on them. Like a boss. Well, then again, that's not really out of the ordinary, actually, because we're playing as Azhag. He actually used battle tactics. So, it's not weird that we're using actual plans. Victory is in our grasp. Excellent. Now our goblins are stabbing these guys, so that's good. Lads. Oh shit. cast it on Mash One Finger. And there we go, victory. So that was a siege battle, so this army is just going to be destroyed, so I don't have to chase him down. And it was defensive, and we got Total Wa as an achievement. Win a battle with a Wa army as reinforcements. Awesome, so I'll see you guys on the campaign map. Alright, so we're back. So there we go, the Top Knot's grand army has been destroyed. We got a lot of money from that, that's awesome. We also got a Sword of Strife for Azhag, I guess. Someone leveled up. Azhag leveled up. That's great. So there we go. That's cool. So we are going to occupy. There we go. So yeah, the Wa army, just in case it messes up, I'm going to call it on them again. What do we need to do to win this campaign? I know we're nowhere near it, obviously. We need to destroy all of the orcs. All right. A lot of them are gone. There's only the Red Eye, the Crooked Moon, the Bloody Spears, and the Top Knots. Occupy, loot, raise, or sack 50 settlements. We only have 6. Control all of the dwarf holds. Oh, gosh. Okay. We haven't even started on that. That's fine. Destroy the Empire and the dwarfs. Get that money. Ensure that Archaon is in a wounded state. So I don't even have to keep Chaos in the in the wastes. That's cool. And winning this way is basically the same. All right. That's fine. So we have the Bloody Spears all the way over there. They might get destroyed by someone. We have the Crooked Moon, who only have Black Iron Mines, so they'd be pretty easy to get rid of. The Red Eye are all the way up there. I don't even know what they're doing. And then the Top Knots we have to get rid of as well. All right, so now the Top Knots. How strong are they? 33, and we're 21. They don't want peace, though. That's fine, though. I'm ready to start conquering those bastards. Oh, wow. If we had more units in this army, we'd be able to start a Wa with him as well. Ooh, I definitely want to do that. Let's get some units for him. Oh, we can't right now. All right. Let's get him over there. Azhag leveled up. So what were we working on? Okay, the Dubois. Or we could get Savages. I think more melee attack. Yeah, going from 7 and also charge bonus. Yeah, that would be very useful. We'd do a lot of damage that way. So our Wa army is going to take that back before they have a chance to reinforce more, or replenish more, rather. This place is meh. This place is really pissed off because of all the fighting, I guess. But that's fine. We got a lot of money out of it. These rebels are building their force to attack Black Crag, so that's a cool battle that'll happen eventually. But yeah. Okay. So yeah, if we can get some units for this guy, that'd be awesome. Because then he'd start a Wa as well. And then we could use him to take on these dwarfs maybe. Or we use him in the, yeah, we'll use him against the other orcs as well. So I lost a couple of units there, which kind of sucks. But honestly, oh, actually, I think you need 17 units. Or maybe, yeah, okay. I think they still stick around either way, but risky. So let's just recruit one unit. It'll take 2 turns. I'm special. And then next turn we'll recruit some guys there as well. All right. So let's end the turn. These guys should be able to besiege the city then. Or get next to it at least. Come for Grimgor's mercy. What do you want? They want a defensive alliance. Honestly, I don't think so. They're not going to be that useful. I think they're already at war with the dwarves here anyway, so there's no point. Yeah, see? God damn it, I knew it. But there was nothing I could do about that. Shit. I lost my Wa. The tribe's ready. Oh, now these guys aren't going to get theirs. What? Really? That's stupid. What? I don't have any military buildings here. Oh my god. I had one here. And now those dwarfs are gonna take it. Oh, god damn it. I can't believe I lost my Wah army. Oh, god. You gotta be joking. That's an annoyance. It's so stupid that you need 17 units. You shouldn't need that many. It's so easy to lose 3 units in a battle. And then your friggin' WAG disperses. That's stupid. Oh, the Bloody Spears were destroyed, so that's one less that I have to worry about. And yeah, they took it. Fucking great. That's a full army of probably elite dwarfs. Lovely. If you can tell from my tone, I'm very fucking pissed off at that. That is absolutely stupid. What? That's very stupid. Well, can I get peace with the stupid top knots? Because, oh my god. Where's my madness? Come and die. They'll never gonna take peace. They're never gonna take peace from me. Jesus Christ. Juggle. You gotta be joking. That's so stupid. Why? Why? Losing fucking 3 units is ridiculous. Whatever, I'm gonna regret. I'm not gonna be able to beat this army. I already know that. I have no elite troops at all. I'm gonna be bringing 29 units against 20, and they probably have a lot of good shit. Beautiful. The rebels might attack now. Oh, no, they didn't. Alright. Oh, they left. Oh my god. Okay. So I can screw them over with this. Good. Does it have a garrison already? A small one, okay. So I should be able... Okay, before we do that turn, I am going to give him 3 units so that he might get a WAG back. So this guy leveled up while he was under siege. I might give him that just to help. The garrison here... Oh, yep. The garrison here is ridiculously good. We won't have to ever worry about losing that. I will not disgrace my answer. Yeah. See, look how they're growing in straight. They're growing like all multiple ranks every turn. I can already tell in like 2 turns they're probably gonna have another huge army with probably another fucking Wah with my luck. But hopefully if we can take this, we'll get another WAG. Sorry, I'm a little bit teeved off because of how long I've been dealing with this campaign today. So, don't mind me. Alright, I'm gonna give him... Well, the only thing I can give him is Orc Boys, so we'll give him 3 units of Orc Boys. And we're going to declare war. I don't care if it pisses everybody off, we're Orcs! I'll just auto-resolve it. Lost 11 guys, no big deal. We're gonna reoccupy that. Oh wait, yes, we can't get a WAG yet because we need to wait a little bit. Right, we need to wait a few turns anyway. Oh, they tore down my friggin' barracks. What a bunch of dicks. Upgrade that. So Azhag leveled up again, which is great. What are his abilities up here? I'm gonna get back here. 16 leadership. Ooh, that could be pretty good. Does it affect 1 unit? Allies in range. Okay, so that would be really useful. I'm gonna go for that. There's 11 turns on this until the surrender. We're not gonna be taking attrition yet. I mean, I could attack. You know what? Yeah. This army on the field would absolutely crush these guys, but I'm gonna see if I can get a siege out of it, because I want you guys to see a siege. We haven't done one yet, I don't think, in this campaign, so... Oh, this place is gonna rebel. Shit. We'll see how that goes, though. It might not be too bad. So yeah, we're at war with the dwarfs again. They went from 20 to 10 in one turn. That is ridiculous. They definitely have another, like, huge army ready. Probably going to come right out of the shadows and attack Valea Soro or something. If I take this, I might try to take Crad Tommen as well, which is actually really garrisoned. I might try to take those, or take this, I mean, and maybe try to get peace. They might want peace again anyway. Come then, no, they won't want that for a few turns. Maybe I'll have to destroy their main army or something, but either way, we should be fine. So lend another turn. Okay, they rebelled at Crooked Fang Fort. They might actually take that this turn. Yep. Ah, for fuck's sakes. Rebels should not be allowed to attack. Shouldn't be allowed to attack on the turn that they spawn. That's so annoying and stupid. Especially in a game like this where you can't have, like, hundreds of armies. Absolutely ridiculous. I'm gonna be outside of reinforcement range, so they can probably attack. Yep, they can take it. Oh my god, that's so stupid. And I won't get near close enough. Ridiculous. Alright, let's get some more boys. We gotta build up his army, because he can get a walk. Alright, we're actually gaining it now. I mean, this place is already rebelling, so it doesn't matter. We're not taking attrition still, which is good. And yeah, if the dwarves could probably take this. Oh, why? See, if I could just be in reinforcement range, that'd be so good. But I don't think I will be. And they're going to take it. But that actually has, like, a good garrison. Not good, but it's big. So that would have made me able... that would have enabled me to defeat this army easily. So we have 27 minutes left. So we have a new research, so we'll go for that. Biggin Bullies. Leadership for Goblins. That's not really useful. Armor for orc boars. Speed for Wolf Riders. Reload time for that. Unlocks recruitment of Arachnarok, which requires a Goblin Workshop. All of these require the Goblin Workshop. Alright. Well, we'll go for this anyway. Where was it that I built this workshop? It was here. Nope. Where was it that I built it? Oh, it must have been. Yeah. So we need to go to level... You gotta be kidding me, I built it in the wrong spot. Oh, man. I'm gonna have to work on that later, then. Shit. That was a big mistake. So yeah, he's recruiting his orcs. I mean, we could even do that to get quicker recruitment as well, so another turn we'll get even more. Yeah. So yeah, we'll end the turn, and we'll see what happens. The dwarfs might attack, the other dudes might attack. Oh, they use the underway to go somewhere else. I don't know where that other place was, but they did attack Black Crag. So guys, we're going to be starting next episode with this assault of Black Crag, or the defense of Black Crag, I guess. So if you enjoyed, guys, please be sure to leave a like and a comment down below, as always. And if you're enjoying this series, make sure you subscribe, because we're going to be bringing this out every couple of days. Thank you to Haxo, Nicholas, Johnny, and Fish for pledging $5 or more per month on Patreon. You guys are the best, and I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.